Service Tax, Point of Taxation Rules, abbreviated as POTR, and the rules run like this. This is called Rule 3. This is the name number given is Rule 3. If the invoice is raised, is issued within 30 days from date of completion of service, COS means, we are given the abbreviations here, COS means completion of service, DOI means date of invoice, DOP means date of payment, WEE means whichever is earlier. We have used these abbreviations here because abbreviations have got its own magic for the sake of memory. Memory works based on abbreviation. That's the reason why abbreviations have been used here. Instead of lengthy words like this, the mental eye catches these things very fast. Let's say you just memorize this, but this is explained in this fashion here. And this is explained in this fashion here. So if date of invoice is lesser than completion of service, so if date of invoice is issued within 30 days from the completion of service, then whichever is earlier, point of taxation is whichever is earlier, date of invoice or date of payment, whichever happens earlier is point of taxation. Coming to this, if you have not understood this at this stage, do not worry. When we take up a problem, you'll understand it easily. If invoice is not issued within 30 days from the completion of service, this means two things: issued after 30 days or not issued at all. Both mean the same. For us, it is not issued within 30 days from the date of completion of service. That means date of completion of service, invoice raised is after 30 days of completion of service or no invoice at all. Then whichever is earlier is point of taxation. Completion of service or date of payment, whichever is earlier. Let us see how this works out in a problem. There's a problem here. Date of completion of service, we have given four cases. Date of invoice, four different ones. Date of receipt of payment, four different cases. Case 1, case 2, case 3, case 4. Let us see how it works out in each cases. So let me do a little bit of working, a little bit of writing down a format for you. The rulings will be, let us have four columns here. This is point of taxation column, just a column enough to write the date, and whichever is earlier point of it, and this is a small version is okay, then yes or no column and again a date column. Let us start naming them. Point of taxation, this is date of giving the problem says date of completion of service. Date of completion of services and date of invoice. Let me give one more date of invoice column here. Date of invoice column. Date of payment column, then is invoice raised within 30 days. This column is invoice raised within 30 days. If invoice is issued within 30 days, invoice issued within 30 days, yes or no. If yes, then whatever rules applies, whichever is earlier, then point of taxation. So we have these columns. Let us take the first case, completion of services 5-4-2015. The completion of services on that day, date of invoice is 18-4. 2015. Date of payment is 15/5/15. So you have these three dates picked up from the problem. This is the solution part. So these three dates are copied, case one, from here. Now for us, is the invoice issued within 30 days from COS, from completion of service? So completion of service is 5th of April 2015. 30 days from 5th of April 2015 is 3rd of May, one day before 5th of May. 5th of May becomes the 31st day. So 3rd of May or 4th of May, one day before 5th. 4th of May 2015. So this 14th April is before 1 month. So it is much earlier than 4th of May. So this is earlier than. So invoice is issued within 30 days. Yes. Is invoice issued within 30 days from completion of service? Completion of service 5th April. 30 days from that is 4th May. And this date is earlier than 4th May. So is invoice issued within 30 days? Yes. If yes, whichever is earlier. What is the rule? For us, the rule is, now we are in this part of it. So either this happens or this happens. Both of them cannot happen simultaneously. So invoice is issued within 30 days. These rules apply. If this doesn't apply, then these rules apply. One of the two applies, but both cannot apply at the same time. So these rules apply. We can forget about this now. We'll go by this. So 30 days means whichever is earlier, date of invoice or date of payment. So I can write down here, date of invoice or date of payment, whichever is earlier. Date of invoice for us, now let's just compare these two columns. I can forget about this column, date of completion of service, irrelevant. These two columns, whichever is earlier, date of invoice column or date of payment. 14th April or 15th May, this is earlier, 14th April is earlier. Date of invoice is earlier. So point of taxation is, 18th April, not 14th April, 18th April. 18th April 15. This is earlier compared to this. Date of invoice is earlier compared to this. So date of invoice. So point of taxation is 18th April. Hope this is clear. Hope this is easy. If you are through, then we'll go to the next line item, next problem. Completion of service 1st May. Date of invoice 25th. May. Completion date of payment 20th April. Now, again, the question. Is invoice issued within 30 days from completion of service? Here. Is invoice issued within 30 days from completion of service? Completion of service 1st May. 30 days from 1st May is 31st May. This is issued on 25th May. Invoice is issued on 25th May. So it is within 30 days. Yes. If yes, again, date of invoice or date of payment, whichever is earlier. Now for us, if we check these two dates, again, forget about this because date of completion becomes irrelevant. We can forget about this. Date of invoice or date of payment, whichever is earlier compared to these two. 20th April is earlier than 25th May. So this one, date of payment is earlier. Date of payment is 20th April. So that becomes point of taxation. If you are through with this, we'll go to the third case, 12th April case. If you have not understood, put it on pause, rewind, run through these rules, apply these rules to this problem and get the solution. So we'll go on to the third case, 12th April 15. 12th April 15, date of completion of service, date of invoice 15th May 15, date of receipt of payment 10 June 15. Now, is invoice issued within 30 days from completion of service? Completion of service 12th April, 30 days from 12th April is 11th May. This is issued on 15th May, so no, it is not issued within 30 days, it is issued after 30 days, it is issued after 11th May, it is issued on 15th May, so no. If no, then these rules apply. If it's issued within 30 days, this will apply. If not invoiced, if invoice is not issued within 30 days, these rules apply. So we can forget about this. Now we'll have to check these rules. So now, whichever is earlier, point of taxation, whichever is earlier, cost of completion of service or date of payment, whichever is earlier. Now COS or DOP, whichever is earlier. So I'll have to forget date of invoice column. I can close this column, forget it, and compare these two, completion of service or date of payment. Compare this with this. Which is earlier? 12th April is earlier than 10th June. So 12th April. So completion of service is earlier. So point of taxation is this or this, whichever is earlier, completion of service. I've picked up cases in such a way that each of them you'll get one earlier date. Date of invoice, one problem. Date of payment, one problem. Completion of service, one problem. Now we'll go on to the fourth case. 20th May, completion of service. 26th June, date of invoice. 14th April, date of payment. Now, same question. Is the invoice issued within 30 days from completion of service? Completion of service 20th May. 30 days from 20th May is 19th May. This invoice is issued on 26th June. Not in the month of May, it's issued next month. So it is much beyond 30 days. So no. Is invoice issued within 30 days? No, not issued. It is issued after 30 days. Then what are the rules? Issued after 30 days, whichever is earlier, cost of completion of service or date of payment, whichever is earlier. Now in this case, which is earlier? So I'm going to close this. Date of invoice is irrelevant, not to be compared. 20th May or 14th April, which is earlier? 14th April comes earlier than 20th May. So date of payment. The date of payment is 14th April. So this is completion of service. So this is date of point of taxation for us. With this, we are through with this problem. Run through this slowly. Run through these rules, problem, apply these rules to this problem, we'll arrive at the solution. With this, we are through. Run through this slowly.